alle canto tie, io stavi al voti te. Canto tie, io staria un po' di te.
Er nahm mich wie der Wiesenhans, mit Lohn in der Zenter, er wist nicht, du Wiesen lang, balle fraudulenter. Oi, etto e.
Balle di canto tie, io staria un po' di te.
Es hat ein linder Wohlgefallen und Procula via, da hab ich meine Herzen an, die Pannung von mir. Oi, oi,
oi, oi, oi,
Er gleich mir an den Wiesen lieb, nun aufs Quick Imore, er fragt mich nachher sich ein Witz, dulziges Gumore. Oi, jetzt, oi, jetzt.
Malle di canto tie, juxtami an posite.
Er lacht mir auf das Händelin, corpore detecta, er rannte mir in das Burgelin, cuspide erecta. Er nahm den Schutscher unter den Bogen, den Venator, derselbe hätte mich betrogen. Oh, das Kompleator, oi, et oi.
Alle Cantortini, io stavi an posite. Alle Cantortini, io stavi an posite.
The past 10 or 15 years have seen a sudden explosion of groups specialising in early music, many of them in particular types or particular periods of music. You join us today in the Universal Hall Arts Centre at Findhorn in Murrayshire for a concert given by one of those groups, the new London Consort, directed by Philip Picket. One of the reasons this music remained unknown for so long was simply that it dates from a period before the invention of music printing. Performers play from printed music, scholars study manuscripts, and seldom did the twain meet. The new London Consort has consistently sought out and performed hitherto unpublished material. This began with their work on the famous Carmina Burana manuscript, and we'll be hearing extracts from that later. Firstly, though, music by Oswald von Wolkenstein. He'd be a dynamic and colourful figure in European history, even if he hadn't been a poet and musician, as well as a politician, a mercenary soldier, a diplomat, and a famous lover. He was imprisoned several times, he fathered at least 7 children, and he retained his favourite mistress long after his marriage. And you can hear a lot of this in his music. Wholehearted enjoyment of life and life's pleasures was what Oswald was interested in expressing. No wonder that his music broke all the formal rules of the elegant, courtly song of his day. But it has a directness and a gusto that make it hard to believe that he was born 600 years ago.
Stammt aus Marede, Liebesgrede, durch die Lämmer aus. Sind ein Set zu frischen Kraft, ein Fisch, leuchtet der Wurst auf die Schüssel. Wer mit Pulsa knackigieren lächt, aus dem Haus wird der Leuchter hier. Stammt aus Marede,
Liebesgrüne,
leuchtet ihr an Bord aus. Kippen Sie zum Beispiel Gott, ein Fuß, leuchtet ihr wohl aus auf die Schüssel. Wann hier auch ein Kleid,
ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein Kleid, ein
Verhältnis für die Liebe wäre nicht mehr.
Kriegt noch den Staden, durch die Nadel, knirchen mit. Da wird die Schereite sicher links vorbei. Ganz getrennt mit der Dämpfung bleibt mir. Zwei Torbeiche auf und schrei nicht laut. Dein Schand wird freut sehr sicherlich ins Mal. Kriegt noch den Staden, durch die Nadel, knirchen mit.
There has been a lot of information come to light since the 70s. For example, we know now that instruments did not play a major role in the performance of Burgundian chanson. Either they were sung or they were played, and generally the instruments and the voices were not mixed. That's just one example. We tend to use women. We know very well that the countertenor had very little to do with secular performance in the Middle Ages, but we do know now that women had rather a lot to do with the performance of secular music in the Middle Ages.
There are two decisions that the performer has to make that it strikes me there's rather little evidence to help him. One is the sort of voice that you shall use in the case of vocal music, and the other is tempo.
We know a little bit about the vocal sound because if you listen to the instruments, you can come to decisions about vocal sound which will match the instruments. I mean, we know how a rebec sounds because it sounds like a rebec throughout the Arabic world.
Ich klag das Wort, des mich nicht her. Man hört die Vogel in den Haus mit hellem Schaller klingen schon. O Nachtigall, dein Zwergton mir bringet an, des ich nicht von. Und weiblich muss ich klagen.
We know about something called tactus, which was based on the heartbeat. So we can make theories about how fast a piece of music should go. We are not actually playing for a 13th century audience, that's very important. And so we don't necessarily try too hard to worry about things like tempo. We do worry about things like tuning. We can't necessarily always use their tuning systems, but we can try and elicit an emotional response from an audience at the points where their tuning system would have made it a very obvious reaction.
Und du mir doch nicht mehr. Fröhlich geschweigt, so wenn wir machen, 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 den Zwerg uns nicht gewöhnt. Jungfrau, sind wir einmal der Gezerrt, so lachen sie ihren Held und es sie ungeschämt. Frage, frage, des Weines käme, so schön, sprach es meines Tieren erhoben auf der Bank. Mach lang, Geselle, man hat immer Dank, dein Gesang und Getrank, uns ist der Winkelmann und wir freuen uns. Schmutz macht mein Frau und du wäsche bietet mir noch meinen gleichen Stil. Das du nicht heizen und jeden damit und sich dann geben, das wird sich snäger. Oh weh, jetzt hast du nimmer, so von der Kina, von der so ist. Herr, nicht als ABC und tu mir doch nicht weh.
People don't imagine that there were concerts in the Middle Ages. They think that a minstrel came along after dinner and played to entertain. Well, I have a woodcut of a man sitting on a stage playing a viol or medieval fiddle. And in front of him, there are many benches filled with listeners, and some of them are actually asleep, just like a modern audience. Well, we are thinking very much of our audience. Most of our audiences do not understand medieval Latin. They do not understand medieval Italian or medieval German. So we try to help them. For example, here we will be performing some music from the Feast of Fools. That needs a lot of explanation. It's pretty near the knuckle. I mean, there's a Kyrie, and in the middle donkeys start braying. You have to explain it.
Yes, tell me about the Feast of Fools and the music associated with it.
Well, once a year, the clergy decided they'd had enough of being good, and everything was reversed. For example, the altar boy became bishop for the day, and the bishop became the altar boy. The monks or clerics tore their garments. They sat in choir with their books upside down. They imitated animals in the church. They daubed themselves with excrement. They burnt old shoes instead of incense. And they parodied all the rites of the church.
Lux orie, lux laetitiae, meiudice, tristis quis quis erit remo bellus erit solemnibus istis. Sint odie procul in virie, procul omniam esta. Leta volunt qui cumque colunt a sinaria festa.
A sinaria festa.
Come dite caduto, parera, segue camminarea, e si rasnesse.
Thank you.
te facias, et nos a tuas nuptias, o catus rex usipias.
Calendas januarius, solemnes Christe facias, et nos a tuas nuptias, o catus rex
Veni, Patris, et Gloria, Tibi Christe Victoria, Nematis in tequaria, per seculorum secula.
Novos annos, dies annos,
patria
si tutti ci reparando via
Take a concrete case. You're performing music from the Benedict Boyan manuscript, Carmina Burana, of which a good many of the standard musical sources say, alas, we cannot perform these songs, we cannot read them if you are performing them.
Well, that's very simple. The manuscript itself contains over 200 poems or pieces, plays, whatever. And many of them have neumes over the words. Now, the neumes are little dots and dashes. They do not tell you the pitch or rhythm of the melody, but they do tell you whether the melody goes up or down. So you can hypothesize, if you like, that here we have a melodic shape. Luckily, those poems also exist, or rather some 48 of them exist, in other concordant manuscripts. And here they appear with what we know of as a stave. Again, it doesn't tell us the rhythm of the tune, but it does tell us the pitch. Now, if the pattern of pitches from the Concordant manuscript follows the pattern of pitches in the Carmina Burana manuscript, then you can be fairly sure that that is the Carmina Burana melody. Now, as far as rhythm is concerned, that is purely an editorial decision. And I tend to work in terms of a combination of the natural rhythm of the poetry, it's very doggerel, Latin poetry, together with a very good idea of the rhythmic modes that were employed in part music of the time. So we have a combination of these elements in our performances. The book itself was ordered, if you like, in a special way, rather like an encyclopedia. And at the beginning, there are satirical pieces or poems attacking the church. Then there are pieces about fortune. Then come pieces about love and springtime. Then about eating and drinking. And finally, there are religious plays. So in fact, it's a very, very wide-ranging anthology. We have come to know the poems of the Karloff version and think from that 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 is what Carmina Burana is about. In fact, it's much broader.
Fervende corspetti e mendas Etse merces optime, conspice nitorem, ec tibi convenium, ad vultus decorem. Ex sunt odorifere, quasi comprobaris, corporis flagrantia, omnem super avis.
Thank you.
stare o.
Io l'amore di dinare posso fare o.
Est quellarum quam diligo, et rosa rosarum quam sepe video, oh, oh, tuctus toreo.
Iam amore divinari tuctus areo, nobis nobis amore profereo.
Mea me confortat commissio, mea me deportat negatio, oh, oh, tuctus fareo.
Iam amore divinari tuctus fareo, nobis nobis amores profereo.
Mea me cum ludit virginitas, mea me detrudit simplicitas, oh, oh, tuctus fareo.
Iam amore divinari tuctus fareo, nobis nobis amores profereo.
Tempore, surge cantilera re pectore, oh, oh, totus fareo.
Iam amore divinari totus fareo, nobis nobis amores profereo.
Tempore brumari vir patiens, animo vernali lasciviens, oh, oh, totus floreo.
Iam amore divinari totus fareo, nobis nobis amores profereo.
Veni domicella cum gaudio, veni, veni pulchra iam pereo, oh, oh, totus floreo.
Iam amore divinari totus fareo,
that you can never ever say that this is how a piece of medieval music sounded. You can say perhaps that this or that would not or could not have been done. Every year we come nearer to a clearer understanding of what they did, either through reconstructing the instruments and having them set up properly, learning to play them properly, or all the other musicological things. We can never say that that is how it sounded. It's too long ago